PureCircle is a Malaysia-based consumer goods company that's all about stevia, a plant sweetener being used in 86 cola drinks around the world as concern over obesity grows. The group is the world's leading producer of high-purity stevia ingredients, and they want to change how the world thinks about sweetness. They're passionate about reducing calories with a naturally sweet option that doesn't compromise on taste and doesn't wreck the planet. Well, for more about this global vision and mission and the business plan behind it, I'm joined by Magomet Malsagov, the Chief Executive Officer and founder of PureCircle. Well, thanks ever so much for coming in. Now, you founded this in 2002. What's the thinking behind it? Tell me a little bit about what stevia is.
Right. Stevia is a natural plant that originates in South America. Guarani Indians in Paraguay, Argentina, Brazil consume leaves coming from stevia plant in form of tea. They make tea out of it. So it's been around for hundreds of years there. Probably around 100 years ago, Japanese picked that up and brought it to Far East, and it's been used in a cooled extract form, pretty much like tea, extract from tea leaves in Far East since probably mid-50s. They did not use it as a sweetener primarily, they use it as a flavor enhancer because it has those properties as well.
But now all that's changed, hasn't it?
It changed because we brought in science into it. In that leaf, you have about 50 different molecules. Some of them are good sweeteners, some of them are good flavors. The science was to identify the right molecules that can be applied for right application, whether it's sweetener or flavor, and then produce them in scale. So from extract, it went a step further where you go into a highly refined, purified individual molecules coming out of leaf that have good taste profile or flavor profile.
And you talk about the taste, and of course many people know it's used in lots of soft drinks, lots of colas and lemon drinks, some iced teas as well, but fewer people might know. I've got some here. I mean, some pretty household names. It's in lots of everyday foods, isn't it?
That is correct. Stevia today has been used pretty much everywhere where sugar is used, from cough syrups in pharmaceutical industry to all the way to chewing gums and everything in between, whether it's beverages, baked goods, confectionery, everything where sugar is used today, stevia is used.
So a good space to be in there. It seems like you're in the right place at the right time.
It is. Our addressable market is about $90-odd billion, 70 of which is sugar and other sweeteners. 20-odd is flavors because stevia has... we also produce products from stevia that I use as flavors, not as sweeteners. So it's a big market. If you look at some structural challenges out there, obesity, diabetes, over 2 billion people are overweight, 600 million people are obese, over 400 million people are diagnosed with diabetes. These are pretty big numbers and they're growing.
So your market is huge, and that's been reflected, I suppose, in your sales. I think up to 26% in 6 months to June. And you were saying to me before we came to air that that's been a steady trend over the last few years.
Yes, last 3 years, if you look at our numbers, we have grown roughly about 40% compounded annual growth rate. It's not a straight line usually. You have ups and downs, but average about 40%.
Well, talking of ups and downs, I mean, if you look at your share price, it's not at the highs it was at, is it, in 2014. What are the challenges that you're facing?
You know, young businesses, new industries, they never... you always have challenges, you know, it's never a straight line. But structurally, this has been a long-term game plan. Addressable market is big. Supply chain needs to be there to service a big market. When it comes to sweeteners, regulatory approvals need to be there. A new sweetener sweeteners are second largest ingredient after water in food and beverage industry, so it's heavily regulated. So getting approvals around the world has been also challenging, but where we are today is literally everywhere where it matters, it has been approved.
So regulatory issues have been a sticking point for you. What about things like the economic situation in China? Is that an issue? I know they put the price up of stevia leaves, which hit you.
Right. It's not the problem. I mean, if you look at this year, Malaysian ringgit weakened, Chinese yuan weakened against the dollar, and we report in dollars. So that's, in a way, good for us. In terms of supply chain, we are not dealing with a commodity. So planning is what needs to be fine-tuned. It's not so much about whether the price of leaf went up this year or not. It's about planning in time and planning properly ahead of time so that you can plant as much as is needed. So supply demand needs to be balanced well, and that then balances your profits. But as a young emerging business, we've really, really focused on top line and our cash margins. Bottom line, usually wobbly, and that's normal when you're building a big business. But key for us is top line and the cash margins so that we earn enough to reinvest every year and grow sustainably.
And you want to grow sustainably. What about partnerships? How important are they to get you in the right markets, to get past that regulatory approval, and to help you grow?
Partnerships are very important. We have done a lot of partnerships over 15 years now. A lot of them with food and beverage companies, big household names as well. A lot of them with trade partners, for example, in the flavor industry. We're not flavor specialists. We do produce flavors, but we outsource that to partners to take them to market.
So you need their skills.
So yeah, we tap, what we do internally is we absolutely focused on what we're good at. And then we'll outsource or partner out lacking skills or knowledge or go-to-market strategy to a third party that can do it better than we do.
You're quite relaxed. I know you take a long-term view and things that are happening here and now don't tend to bother you so much. Why is it important to take a long-term view, and where do you see the company going?
It's absolutely important. Be focused on long-term objective. Where are we going to be 5, 7, 10 years from now? Key at the end of the day is the addressable market. What are you trying to unlock as a market? And then work backwards from there to where you are and you know, get to detailed plans how you get there year on year. So that's how we work. But it all starts from a long-term plan where we want to be. As I said, our addressable market is almost $90 billion, and where we are today is 130 million sales. So. Sure, it's important to be there, but what's important is also you plan 5, 6 years ahead where you want to be 5, 6 years later. So
you're looking for investors who are confident enough to take that longer term view. What do you think investors like about PureCircle? What do they like about you?
Well, I think you probably is the right question to ask our investors, I guess. I think if you go back when we listed the company on AIM back in 2007, and if you look at our admission papers and documents, you would see a long list of risks, which probably still will be there, but a lot of them have gone away, like regulatory clearances, like products on the shelf, whether consumers will like the taste, whether we can scale. So we have really addressed a lot of problems over the years, not to mention structuring the company, putting systems in place. In a lot of cases, if you're not careful, you can grow yourself into bankruptcy, basically. So planning, systemizing your business, we have done a lot of work. And where we are today, I feel very comfortable in our ability to execute. The risk probably is that we are, to some extent, still depend on big brands and how well they will do and how soon they will launch. That's something we cannot influence. And to some extent, we also couldn't influence when governments will get approvals. I mean, you can lobby, but at the end of the day, you depend on their speed and their timing. So I think we have ticked a lot of boxes personally. It's not been a straight line, as many would know, but so far, so good, I think.
So you've ticked a lot of boxes for investors who like big brands. You've problem solved, you've got a long-term vision and a systematic plan in how to achieve it.
That's how we'd like to think
about PureCircle. Thanks ever so much for filling us in. Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me.
I look forward to future updates.
Thank you.